Did you know that in 2012, women made up only 12.8% of the STEM workforce in the UK? It is globally accepted that women have experienced many barriers to entering the science, technology, engineering, and mathematical professions, a reality still faced by many women today. That's why we thought it was important to create a series about women in science, highlighting the groundbreaking contributions made by female scientists, past and present. This first episode will focus on contributions made throughout history and their effects for how we live today. Augusta Ada Lovelace is considered the world's first computer programmer, introducing many computer concepts still used today. She translated an article on an invention by Charles Babbage, known as the analytical engine. Not only did she translate this, but she added her own comments. In fact, her notes ended up being 3 times longer than the original article. In her notes, Ada wrote a set of commands for the still incomplete machine that would allow it to generate Bernoulli numbers. She also theorized a method for the engine to repeat a series of instructions, a process known as looping that computer programs still use today. The paper was published in 1843 under the initials AAL, but it was only 20 years after she died that she was revealed as the author. Cecilia Payne Gaposchkin was a pioneer in the field of astronomy. She was the first to apply the law of atomic physics to the study of the temperature and density of stellar bodies, and was the first to conclude that hydrogen and helium were the two most common elements in the universe. At 25 years old, she challenged the idea that stars were made of heavy elements in her revolutionary doctoral dissertation. Instead, she proposed that our sun, stars, and thus the universe were composed in terms of the relative abundances of hydrogen and helium, the two lightest elements. Her thesis was dismissed as impossible by Henry Norris Russell, but 4 years later, he published a paper of his own reaching the same conclusions. We are all taught that hydrogen is the most abundant element, but few realise who really reached such a conclusion. Emmy Noether was a German mathematician known for her groundbreaking contributions to abstract algebra and theoretical physics. Her work on differential invariance and the calculus of variations became known as Noether's theorem. This has been claimed as one of the most important mathematical theorems ever proved in guiding the development of modern physics. Albert Einstein described her as the most significant creative mathematician genius thus far produced since the higher education of women began. Today, her theorem underpins much of modern physics, and I am sure she's someone I think Sheldon would definitely have at his fantasy dinner table. Rosalind Franklin was a chemist and renowned X-ray crystallographer who contributed to the understanding of the fine molecular structures of DNA, RNA, viruses, coal, and graphite. In fact, it was her significant research that was instrumental for discovery of the structure of DNA. Rosalind created Photograph 51, an X-ray diffraction of the B form of DNA. Most people attribute the research discerning the structure of DNA to Watson and Crick, but in reality, the structure is based on this critical photograph. The photo was acquired through 100 hours of X-ray exposure from a machine Franklin herself had refined. In January 1953, Maurice Wilkins disclosed Rosalind's photo 51 without her permission or knowledge to competing scientist James Watson, who was working on his own DNA model with Francis Crick at Cambridge. Photo 51 was then used as the basis for the model of DNA that Watson and Crick received a Nobel Prize for in 1962. Her contributions were downplayed for years, and she received little credit before she died. Hedy Lamarr was a Hollywood actress, but also a mathematician and inventor. In fact, she co-invented the frequency hopping spread spectrum, a technology still used in modern Bluetooth and Wi-Fi and key for many wireless communications. In 1942, she, along with George Antheil, patented an idea for a secret communication system. This changed radio frequencies to keep enemies from decoding messages. The wide-ranging impact of this technology was only recognised years later. In 1997, both were honoured with the Electronic Frontier Foundation Pioneer Award, and that same year, Lamarr became the first female to receive the Bulby Nass Spirit of Achievement Award, considered the Oscars of inventing. Now, who said science wasn't glitzy?